shown up in a mighty way. And so now it's time to just sit back and relax and be blessed by what's going to happen. A couple of announcements, because we're the Salvation Army, and that's what we do. Tomorrow morning, we have a very, very, very important component of the Young Adult Retreat, and that is you're going to meet with your division in divisional ministry plan groups. It's wonderful if we're on the mountain. We are blessed on the mountain. But what do we do when we go down from the mountain? So the locations are assigned in here. Please show up to do this, because this is where we're going to take it back. We've been with Jesus, but we've got to go down. They're the lost, the least, the lonely, and the hurting, and we know the answer. We have the key. Tonight we are very honored. I'm going to do what I want to do. I just want to say in front of this congregation that this young adult retreat happens because of Eric's heart, soul, and his mind. And I, you know, he doesn't even do it for applause. But from the very moment this one is done, he will start thinking about next year. And I have the privilege of working with him, and I have the privilege of watching him develop this from the ground up. And this year, I think you just knocked it out of the park. In the meeting, when we were told who the guests were, I kind of got a little excited. I know I may be the oldest person in the room, but that's okay, because the opposite of old is dead. So I think I'm really lucky. And a couple of years ago, I got to go to Dare to Share, and I heard Propaganda. And it didn't take me but maybe five words, and I fell in love with him. Now, I wrote a whole rap, and I left it in the room. But we're going to do that. We're going to go with it. And so tonight we're going to have this amazing band of six friends who met in college and played around through campus life and decided to lead worship for all to hear. And then they came, and now they're here. And so tonight we're going to be blessed in a concert of theirs, and you can get their merch on the table out there. I'm not done. Three are married, one has a child on the way, one has a 9 and a 5 that they can play. The sister's not here, the spirit of the band, she's home. We don't know why she missed the van. But tonight we're going to hear the band once again in a concert form in praise and worship. They're known on the streets. It's not the church where they want to be. They want to be out where the people can see Christ in them as they sing and they play, and we've been blessed yesterday and today. With an uncompromising message entwined with rhythm and beats, the man known as Prop, or is it Mr. Aganda, is known on the LA streets. His real name is Jason. His wife's a PhD. His daughter is 8. Make sure the word she'll get when she's late. So he comes tonight, and he speaks truth with strength. And his hair is so long, he must not cut it. I think not lost the train of thought. Not done. Getting back in my role here. No one's giving me a beat either. I asked Marcarius and he went, no. Just no. Prop has gained national and international following year after year. For Dare to Share, he brought me a tear when he presented the gospel of life in 6 words. If you haven't had it for your teens, you can buy it, I'm sure. Propaganda's a man who knows Christ as his Lord, and so do the men from Florida, too. They worship him, praise him, and love him each day. And so now tonight, let's welcome him this way. Thank you.
Are you guys going to come join me or what? Are you going to sit there like this isn't a hip-hop concert? You better come fill this up. It's all good. I'll wait for you, though.
I will wait for you.
Was that not the most epic intro ever? Delusional, this most likely is your first experience for me. Greetings, my name is Propaganda. I wrote my first rap in 93, simply put. Fire-baptized battle rapper who's heavily influenced by folk music and found creative freedom in poetry. Combo is strange, I know, but let this one bake your noodle. I'm the son of a Black Panther with a Mexican spouse and Caucasian best friends. And my writing tone, well now, is not one that offers you a neat little bow to tie all your little problems up with. I know enough to know that I don't know that much. I know God became a man to save us, and we still can't explain pyramids. I know ancient Mayan and Egyptian astronomers had a far greater understanding of outer space than we do. I know academia is so drunk on arrogance and racism that they'd rather credit these accomplishments to aliens than to admit that we are not the smartest civilization to ever live. I know I really love my wife, my daughter, and mangoes. And for some reason, folks find it illogical to think that a perfectly designed universe screams of a designer. I know sarcasm is the only time most people tell the truth. I know chilaquiles and In-N-Out will be served in heaven. I know it's a much better decision to shut your mouth if you don't know what you talk about than to validate what everybody already thinks of you. I know color theory very well. I got a degree in illustration and intercultural studies and a teaching credential, yet I rap for a living, let that sink in. Apparently I don't know that much, just the gospel and good hip-hop. Pretty simple dude, all I got is my all, and I promise to give you that. You know lower standards are lower the culture. You know the Roman Empire was destroyed by lower standards and moral decay. You know they fed their own alliance for entertainment, humans. Went up to their own devices, seem to be hopelessly selfish and bent on their own destruction. It seems unless a force greater than us intervenes, nothing will stop that trajectory. Wealth, knowledge, success seems to only feed the beast. But don't listen to me, we just met. What do I know? That's my man DJ Rhino representing Gary, Indiana. Yeah. So we're gonna have a good time today. I'm gonna do some hip hop, some poetry. I'm gonna expect y'all to participate like you've been doing hip hop your whole life. And if you haven't before, you can pretend we're family. You guys ready? Here we go. You guys ready? Let's holler at them. Listen, they say the places we venture a Christian shouldn't dare. Homie, that ain't holiness, it's fear, you scared. I swear I won't see him by osmosis. I got a blood-bought prognosis from the age with soccer blades, hell, get a blaster. Thing is Christian rap for the rappers who believe. Stand your ground, pound a mic consistent with the truth you speak. You can watch the gospel stand on its own 2 feet. Really ain't that unique? Y'all just never seen it. Unlike the elephants, I won't let you ignore. Like arenas full of white kids all singing along. Make combos in the green room filled with awkward pauses. Think y'all know, but don't trust it, it's all love. Came to provide y'all the soundtrack of life. Like round here are lights, like sounds from the mic, right? Creedence color with they 116 tats. Humble rapper teams all with their hands up. Understand before Grammys and sellers, it was bars from the cellar that's so high in the cellular. Network can't tell you my net worth. I ain't got a clue. Double step a few to the paper to use. Who we win, we get better prepared. Here's what this thing can destroy a turntable. And you ain't gotta understand. Hey, find it or somewhere in your soul. The last bit of strength that'll take you on home. Just find it somewhere in your heart to put the past in the past and go back to the start. Selfish, prideful, come get an eyeful. Ugly dark stain on a once wonderful resume. Leisurely strolls down the road of perdition. Leaves a man wishing for his old position. I know it's so empty, but it's still so tempting. If I ever lose sight, come and get me. You gotta dig. You gotta dig. And if I ever lose sight, come and kiss me. You gotta dig, and she's a jewel in your crown. Don't trade $1 million future for a nickel right now. Mama said leave a place better than you found it. Looking in her eyes, I realize how profound that is. Dig like there's no tomorrow. Dig like you're living on time that's borrowed. Dig, homie, it's in there somewhere. Dig like your life depends on it, cause it does. Dig, my grandmama touched down. Fresh from TX, a block from Ghost Town. A born rider, watch riot survivor. Her four kids, but them streets are a beast. Grace alone, 3 out of 4 made it. Son of second born is rocking microphones. And it's so lovely, wish it could hug me. Dirty and it sticks, but it's mine for the keeps. Cold piece of work, son of a 9-to-5. Civil rights and Vietnam War survivor. They told my grandpappy that blacks were not human. That didn't stop the movement. You gotta dig. And find it. The wind sings the songs of the dedicated few that wouldn't fall headlong. Just find it. Watch me tighten my belt. When the prayers of this rapper's a desperate cry for help, I desire a higher outcome than we get ya. Forgive me if I dismiss ya, ain't to ditch ya. And I am not a roster, don't let the dreads fool ya. I take Josh serious, if it's cold, let me school ya. Dig. I can't say I'm not tired. Felt a little envious, the names on flyers. Empty handed and homesick, though I know I'm flow sick. If y'all only knew how cold this road gets. Dig. If I ever lose sight, come and get me. You gotta dig. I ain't the artist of the canvas. Remind me of my own words, though I can't stand it. Hold me accountable. Call me on my laziness. Call me by my birth name. Look me in the face and dig. Hey, you gotta dig. And if I ever lose sight, come and get me. You gotta dig. Every once in a while, we gotta have our type of honesty with each other and with ourselves. Have somebody with the right to look you in the face and be like, bro, you tripping. And if you ever lose sight, I'll come and get you. You gotta dig. Listen, I came from a hood, and there you learn, man, all you got is each other. Why can't it be different in the body? You guys good? I gotta tell you, you're doing amazing. And that was absolutely incredible. She wrote a rap song for me. And for the to introduce, I've never seen that. That was absolutely incredible. Next year you'll do a whole set? Next year? Okay. Oh, fifth. Huh? That Fiji. Are y'all from Fiji or you just, I mean, it's possible. I wasn't being funny. You just shouting out the water. It's good water. Sorry. The reality is, man, I'm like every possible California stereotype. Like, it's like, I'm vegetarian. I really only eat fish. I'm gluten free. I'm lactose intolerant. I live on a beach. Like, it's all true. Like, it's true about me. Sorry. Anyway, So, like I said, man, again, I'm from South Central Los Angeles. We got any West Coasters in the building? Are y'all freezing like I am? Yeah. But I grew up in a part of town that was predominantly Latino. ¿Dónde está mi Latino? ¿Dónde está mi gente? Se aplauso fuerte. Right? So I grew up in a pretty much all Latino neighborhood. So, although gang life was very present, it wasn't necessarily an option because I would be what you would call a liability. You guys are adults, you know what that means. I try to say that to your youth groups and they're like, what? I'd be like, Google it. Anyway, so I was a liability, you know what I'm saying? But you know, just like you went through it, like I went through it around junior high, you gotta pick like an you know what I'm saying? Like you're a skater, a dancer, ski-er, you gotta pick an right? And I wasn't trying to pick none of the herbs that was offered to me, you know. But I fell in love with hip-hop, right? And if you're familiar with Los Angeles, you know, it was around the 80s when breakdancing kind of hit L.A. really hard. You know, I was a wee tyke then, and was just kind of blown away with, like, you know, I just the idea of, like, standing on a corner, you know what I'm saying, and just being, you know, a real gangster just wasn't cool to me. But the idea of spinning on my head was, you know what I'm saying? Like, I was like, that's pretty amazing, you know what I mean? So I kind of wanted to be a part of whatever that was. I remember driving down the freeway and seeing these murals the size of buildings in this place called the LA River. And if you've ever been to Los Angeles, it's not really a river. Like, it's paved, it's concrete. It's really a rain wash sewer. It's just the size of a building, but it's not really a river. We just call it a river. Anyway, but I remember seeing those murals and just all this graffiti just driving through the city and made the hood all of a sudden seem beautiful to me. And I was like, yo, I want to be a part of this. You know what I mean? So that was like my introduction to hip hop. I fell in love ever since. Kind of just been there. It's been kind of like the soundtrack of kind of the journey that the Father has brought me through. A lot of ups, a lot of downs, a lot of pain, a lot of failures, a lot of near misses, a lot of disappointments from my mother, from my father, a lot of them, from my friends. I lost a lot of friends. I'm pretty sure you guys have lost a lot of friends especially when you made a decision to really pursue the kingdom of God. Or even right now, maybe you not really made an actual decision to pursue the kingdom of God. You just kind of here right now, kind of checked out, which kind of sucks for you because it's a lot of awesomeness going on here. But whatever the case may be, like, it leaves us with situations from our past that are like kind of sucky, right? And if you've ever read Ecclesiastes, what's interesting about the book Ecclesiastes is basically Solomon's argument is life sucks. It just kind of does. I don't know what to tell you. It just sucks, right? It's not going to get better. You should read Ecclesiastes. That's his point. Life sucks and it's not going to get better. That's pretty much the end of the book. You know what I'm saying? Right? But what it teaches us is that we have a better lens. Like, we can enjoy the vanity of it. We can enjoy the mundaneness because we have a perspective of not only a sovereign God, but a sovereign God that is loving. And not only a sovereign God that is loving, but a sovereign God that is loving towards us. Does that make sense? So you can celebrate in the viciousness of whatever life is because you have a different perspective. You understand that God is sovereign and he is completely in love and intimately involved in everything you're going through. And he's weaving a beautiful picture. So having said that, I wrote a new album. I just heard one of the final mixes for one of the last songs just now backstage. I was kind of blown away. So the album's like so done. You know what I mean? But I can't tell you when it's coming out because I don't know when it's coming out. But I know it's very soon. They told me a time. It's just they'll kill me if I tell you when it is. Just know it's really soon. But I'm allowed to perform songs from it. Are you guys cool if I perform songs? Okay, cool. Cool. So the record is called Crimson Cord, right? Essentially, it's that Ecclesiastes concept. Crimson being red and cord being like our timeline. So when you look back in your timeline, you could see that God was kind of working through the ordinary things of life. I've never seen no actual like miracles. Like the sky never parted for me. I've never seen the ocean split. Like it's never happened. You know what I'm saying? At least in my life. You know, what my books, my life's not like Exodus, you know, with like clouds by day and pillars by night. I've never seen that. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's not my life. My life's more like the book of Ruth, where just stuff that sucks was like evidence that like God was working out things. You know what I'm saying? Right. So that's like my crimson cord, right? So I wrote some poetry and I'm doing some new songs for that. Is that okay with you guys? You don't have an option because it's in the set list. So I asked you to be a symbol of the strength I was once given, yet you mocked me. Oh, the mockery. And I place so much confidence in the lessons I swear you taught me, yet you mocked me. Mockery. And you taught me about glory days. You say my best is yet behind me. You just bring up old stuff. Our relationship is so unhealthy, so codependent. You cut me down. You blame me. I blame me. But I'm a man and I won't crack and I won't show emotions right. I do just like my daddy did and his did, and I'll bury you. Well, I built me a mausoleum with a storage unit attached to it just for you. And I've grown so very weary at failing to make you stay there. And I hate it when you show up at my function just so pompous. Without an ounce of shame, you almost ruined my marriage. You mocked me. Oh, the humanity. And I tried to upgrade the way I speak and raise my daughter. But every time I open my mouth, all I hear is my father. And the same foolish pride and pitfalls that he installed, they leak through my pores like poor me. It's so annoying. And I put so much faith in you, but you let me down. I see my own eyes in my 8-year-old when I correct her. Why won't you go away? You smirk as you chase me. You're this coy Helena Troy that toys with emotions, and feeble brain boys like me fall forward every time you mock me. I just can't shake you. I've ran and I've ran, but your stride was identical. Every step I took, your foot fit right in it. Why can't I shake you? I just can't shake you. You are my past. Why won't you stay there? You, that pain that guides us, the strings that tie us, the coincidence that proves to us God's existence, the joy I misplaced, beautiful mistakes, my scarlet thread, my crimson cord. Guides us, the strings that tie us, the coincidence that proves to us God's existence, joy we misplace, beautiful mistakes, the scarlet thread, the crimson cord. Hey, that's the fingerprints of the Lord, a crimson cord, baby, a crimson cord, a timeline, a scarlet thread, a crimson cord, baby, a crimson cord. Let me celebrate your crimson cord, and that's beautiful, a crimson cord, and no regrets, boy, a crimson cord. Evidence of God's love, that's a crimson cord. This the celebration of when the Father sends the hounds of heaven to come rescue. Hey, what it do to a boy's brain to see his father through glass walls? Why algebra homework's less important than last calls? Collect calls come from upstate. You eventually grow numb, it's a sad state. And it's hard to conceive, let alone believe that you're worth it. When your little brother's blood is still stained on your Converse. System leave them hanging, they still binge on syringes. Filled with self-hate, that's why we fly off the hinges. Self-medicate, still struggle at the smell of that fresh kush. Even after salvation, it's tough. Looking back at wasted life, who never had a chance to begin with. Y'all talking about a lamb that's sinless. Pain that guides us, the strings that tie us, the coincidence that proves to us God's existence. Joy we misplace, beautiful mistakes, my scarlet thread, my crimson cord. Your scars out loud. Hey, that's the fingerprints of the Lord. A crimson cord, baby, a crimson cord. A timeline, a scarlet thread, a crimson cord, baby, a crimson cord. Let me celebrate your crimson cord, and that's beautiful, a crimson cord. And no regrets, boy, a crimson cord. Evidence of God's love, it's a crimson cord. Evidence of God's love, it's a crimson cord. What it do to a girl's brain to see her father through FaceTime? Why, if you call her pretty, you can have her at lunchtime. American dream has filled her mama with Botox and personalized license plates, dinner dates. He went to Jared's. Can't conceive or believe that she's worth it. When rather than hanging with you, they buy your designer purses. And you ain't supposed to be mad. Your dad buys you everything, right? We should all wish to have your life. That's why she self-medicates with packages and purchases. Oxycontin morning after pills, no condoms. Suburbia. Both parents, good school, great church, hidden death, cover up, Mac product, not enough. The pain that guides us, the strings that tie us, the coincidence that proves to us God's existence. Joy we misplace, beautiful mistakes, my scarlet thread, my crimson cord. You guys dig it? Good. That Fiji, you know what I'm saying? That's that Fiji. That's that next level, you know what I'm saying? That's that we done moved up, you know what I'm saying? What y'all know is, like, I'm from the city, so there's been plenty of times I done put tap water into a Fiji bottle. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. No, I'm just serious. But anyway, so you guys are super cool, man. I appreciate you guys, man. This is such an honor, dude, being up here. You know, it's not often that I get to the snow and get to be able to do stuff like this. So we're going to end on the highest note as possible. Fist up, fist up, fist up. Let's do it, baby. This last song is a celebration of you guys who chose to move slowly. And what I say by moving slowly is like, it's like cooking barbecue. You have fast cooked barbecue, you got slow cooked barbecue. We all know slow cooked barbecue is much better. It's just like with your life and the race between the tortoise and the hare. Let me make you this promise. The tortoise, he always wins. Y'all ready? Just like this. Up and down, just like this. This last song is called Raise the Banner. The question has never been, what is the banner? The question is always, who is the banner? And his name is Jehovah Nisi. It just means the Lord is our banner. So our promise, with our fist haze, is to march and to follow that banner. Y'all ready? Hey! Sustain the game, stand and bear, raise the banner. You should demand better, homie, raise the banner. Testify, rally, cry under the banner. Shout out King Nisi, follow the banner. For your children, for your neighbors, for your communities, follow the banner. Everybody unashamed, lock your arms, plant your feet, look around, they need you. Dios, Dias. I said, Quias, consider your influence, little ones wanna be us. It ain't about ego, stop thinking so selfishly. Call to be the best is what's best for our community. Consistency, change the future of a family. One goes to college, it breaks the cycle of poverty. I know an ex-vice lord dropped his flags, picked up the pulpit, put a price on his head. Tortoise in the hairstyle, craving the trout. Last week he baptized the guy that put the hit out. Cousin Aaron shooting kites, the arm curling bout, hating his life. And tell me a little more about Christ and gang talk. Fooled the OGs and prison guards. Now he walks the yard he owns. No coulda, shoulda, wouldas. It's all my kinfolk. I read this story a million times. Tortoise always wins. You should demand better. Raise the banner. Testify, rally, cry under the banner. Shots at King DC. Follow the banner. For your children, for your neighbors, for your communities, follow the banner. Everybody unashamed, lock your arms, look around, they need you to follow the banner. Better husbands, better fathers, more servants, more diligence, no excuses, they are useless. You can do this, follow the banner. It takes discipline to be dead to sin. Can't do it alone, you need your kin. Just keep the pace, understand the race. You ain't gotta be fast, just don't run out of gas. The honorable mentions, leave no leftovers, lick the plate of life clean. And thanks to Elohim, no Ponzi schemes, just excellence, just reverence. He is our banner. Just look around, examine creation. It's beautiful, ain't it? The pictures he painted, beeline and finish line. Don't mind if you quote me. Ask why we ain't hot yet. We cooking all slowly. You should demand better. Yeah, testify, rally, cry under the banner. Shout out King Nisi, follow the banner. For your children, for your neighbors, for your communities, follow the banner. Everybody unashamed. Look around, they need you to follow the plan. My hope is this is a real promise for you. Cause I represent that kid that you might serve. Just a kid from the block that needed to see some consistency in my neighborhood. I needed people that were down to follow the banner. Communities. Hey, everybody unashamed, lock your arms, plant your feet, look around, they need you to follow the banner. I consider each and every one of you family. My man DJ Rhino, he considers you family. We're honored to serve, and if you gonna march with me one more time, fist in the air. Everybody say, follow the banner. Come on, follow the banner. Hey, yo, follow the banner. Come on, follow the banner. You guys sound amazing. You guys have rhythm, too. It's amazing. Hope you guys had a great time. My name is Propaganda. That's DJ Rhino. All right, why not? We got a while. Y'all don't mind, do you? All right, go for it. Get my water here. Y'all got to turn up, though. I'm going to give y'all a second to turn up with me. All right. Loosen up. Get yourself some elbow room. We're going to loosen up on this right here. It's a brand new day, y'all. Come on, I can feel it. Hey! We're gonna do just some good old fashioned B-boy stuff right here. Hope y'all don't mind. Hey, slang came from a land where they suffer from the effects of depravity like gang banging and earthquakes. A most famous no-name or split a brain and plain a taste for the gang of gangs. No, it's a strange concept, peddling redemption, boy, what more can I say? Me and Lay Craven trying to make it famous, it's not Trey. These 58s with phrases that would deem us unfit to succeed among these heathens. It's so crucial in the belly of the crucible. You would understand that stage like him or the Tanya, handing out cancer. Fame was never the aim, and the back is the front. Homie, left side up, that's a... misconception. That's what the frame of mind has chosen. I need your brain stimulated. Misconception. That's what your frame of mind has chosen. I need your brain stimulated. Want you cut for? Oh, never mind. Scratch it up for him. DJ Rhino, y'all. Thank you so much, guys.
Hey. You need this?
Thank you. And to think they love Jesus, that's the most important thing. Blessings on you. You are. And that's what I clean my house to. I clean my house to hip-hop music. It always works. Well, now we are blessed to have the band come out. Let's welcome them as they come to bless us. Let them hear you. Let them hear you. I'll check. And let them hear you.
Yeah. tongue. You say, whoa, whoa, whoa. Up the ground. One, two, three. You did it. You didn't just take our sin. Up with your righteousness. Yes, your love. Yes, your love washed over us with your blood. You covered us since your son as one of us. Now your kingdom's here. And amazing grace, you've shown us your mercy. That's right, and you made us. So bring us back, so bring us back to you. Whoa, 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 whoa. Hey, you did it, and you did it. You didn't just take our sin. No, 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 no. You failed us short. With your righteousness. Yes, your love washed over us with your blood. You covered us, sent your son as one of us. Now your kingdom's here, we believe it, God. And amazing grace, you've shown us your mercy. To bring us back, to bring us back to you. Whoa. Into the light, come on. Into the light we will walk straight in. Into the light we will walk. We will walk. Come on, it's all you. You say, into the light we will walk. We will walk. Your presence will lead us into the light we will walk. We will walk. And amazing grace, you've shown us your mercy. And you. You bring us back, you bring us back, you bring us back. Amazing grace, you've shown us your mercy. You made a way to bring us back, to bring us back to you. Bring us back to you. You feeling all right? If there's a way to bring these lights down a little bit, I know I'm putting someone on the spot. It's okay if you can't. If we can just, oh yeah. Feel that? Let's kind of settle into something here. Just embrace this space together here. So I want to tell you a story. In the scriptures, there's a story about a man named Lazarus. If you don't know the name, he's a man who died before his time. Dead and gone. But Jesus, he decided to bring him back. He decided to breathe life back into his bones, to call him up from the grave, to rip him from the darkness, to clothe him in light. You see, Lazarus had been dead for days. But Jesus, he walks right up to the tomb. And he says, "Come out, Lazarus, come out." In an instant, body and soul walks right out of the grave. You see, the most incredible thing about that story, though, is that Jesus came here to do a lot more than raise one man from the dead. So many times we isolate Lazarus like it happened once, you know, like it has nothing to do with us. But what he did to Lazarus, he does to you. He calls you up from the grave. He rips you from the darkness. He breathes life into your bones. So just take a breath tonight. Breathe it in. It's a song called Lazarus.
Come out from your hiding. Ancient of Your glory is power unmatched. Your mercy is life beyond the grave. You're worthy of every breath and all of my praise.
It's just you and God. Give him your heart, you know.
Your glory
is power.
It's power. Your mercy is life beyond.
No holding back.
You're worthy of every breath and all of my praise.
There's no point in holding back. There's just no point in holding back, you know.
Your glory. It's power of magic. Your mercy is life beyond the grave. You are me of every breath and all of my praise. Yes, all of my praise and all of my praise. All of my praise. I know. And I
you mean it, ancient of all days,
ancient of all days, my eternal grace, I belong to you.
We got one more song for you guys, is that all right? Can we get a little rowdy, you know? This here. We just gotta get the blood flowing. It's okay just to let go from time to time. Just to let go. Loosen up. It's a song of perspective. You now need to stop and breathe you in. For my lungs need more than oxygen to take in. The kingdom, feel recreating life. From heaven to earth, our hearts collide. So just split the sky and come Won't you swing the gates wide open? Heaven open up. Let your glory fall right over us. This heaven needs us to magnify your Lord of all. The saints and angels say, this will be caught. We all need new eyes, ignite the light from your hands. Though my vision's clear, I'm still a blind man. If faith is sight in the kingdom, feel recreating life. From heaven to earth, our hearts collide. Just split the sky. Come, won't you swing the gates wide open? Heaven open up. Let your glory fall right over us. This heaven needs us to magnify you, Lord of all. The saints and angels say, as heaven and earth collide. And just be now I see. Take your breath. And just be. Thanks for worshiping with us. Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much. What a wonderfully.
We actually don't have any other songs ready. Sorry about that. Yeah, we know how he loves. You get... you guys know Taste of Eternity? Okay, we can do that. Could we maybe, let's end this night right. Let's maybe get these lights just like all the way gone. You know, you don't even have to see us up here. That's fine. God, we believe that when we sing, you hear us. And we also believe that you delight in our praises, that that you lend an ear to this time. That when we give you glory now, it goes on for eternity. That what happens here echoes forevermore. We catch a glimpse of your glory tonight, that we would sing with our souls, that we would sit at your feet, delight in your presence. Choir tonight. How holy, oh, how holy. There's nothing like you, God, no. Oh, how worthy. This is what we sing forevermore. Oh, how worthy. How worthy. Oh, how worthy. With every breath we sing. Every single breath, with every breath we sing. Give him your very breath tonight, just lay it down. Give him back the breath he's given you, declaring his supremacy and his power and his might and his hope in your life. And every breath, with every single breath, that's right.
Father, we come before you with so, our hearts are so filled. The words we've heard today from our speakers and from propaganda and from this band, we have been in the throne room. Lord, we are just overwhelmed with the outpouring and the anointing that you have placed on this band. Precious, precious young people who are willing to do what you called them to do, what you have given them gifts and talents to do. And we, Lord, have been in the throne room of God because of their faithfulness. And I pray, Father, that you will bless them. Bless them in ways that they just can't even imagine you blessing them because, Lord, of their obedience to you. Meet their needs, Lord. Bless their families, Lord. But most of all, as they sing out this truth with such humble, gentle, sweet spirits, Lord, may the people who hear them be drawn to you, and may lives be changed because of these young men that are behind me. And God, as we come to the end of our day, may we rest tonight knowing that you hover over us. You watch over us as we sleep. And Lord, for every one of the young adults that are here, you have a plan. A plan for good. A plan for kingdom business. And I pray that as propaganda said that scarlet cord, what's behind is behind, and what's before is yet to come. But today we stand in your presence. I thank you, God, for the honor of being here. I'm not going home the same. I don't ever want to go home the same after being at your feet. So, Father, thank you for our day. We know you will go before us tomorrow. And we know that you will show up again. And may we grab a hold of you and not let go. We love you because you are holy and you are worthy and you are the Lamb of God. So in your holy name, Jesus, hear my humble prayer. Good night, beloved. Just like the two on the mountain, they were gone.